Bottom line is this. Tony Romo made the all-pro team. Mm-hmm. That's incredible, and that's ridiculous. You're talking about a guy that's had gone to two Pro Bowls themselves, two Pro Bowls consecutively, three total, and Michael Vick. And you're going to put Tony Romo, a guy that's played eight games in the NFL, ahead of him?
Put Michael Vick at halfback on the Pro Bowl.
Halfback? He's not a running back. I'm going to say it one more time. Yeah, he's a quarterback. And one more thing, Jay. Not personal. Real quick, keep this in mind, okay, Skip? Michael Vick is terror to defensive coordinators. You can't game plan for Michael Vick. If the receivers aren't open, if the line of scrimmage breaks down and someone comes through, guess what? He can take off
and he's faster than anybody else. It's easy to defend Michael Vick. Just say, let's keep him in the pocket because he's about 5'11 and he can't see over anybody.
And if they keep him in the pocket and his receivers catch the ball, this team has got 9 to 10 wins instead of 7.
You're part of the establishment that doesn't want to see this quarterback progress. You don't want to see this guy progress and become one of the best players in NFL history.
I'm disappointed in you, Skip.
I love to watch him. I just don't want him at quarterback.
Skip is about as anti-establishment as they get. One final point on all of this. For those of you that were hoping to see Matt Schaub and Michael Vick in the backfield more, and you've been a big proponent of that, it's not going to happen. Jim Mora came out and said, no, we were just flirting with that because of the injuries, and it's not going to happen anymore.
It shouldn't happen last week.
Well, it won't happen anymore. Yeah. We can tell you that. All right. Now let's talk about the Pro Bowl. You brought up Tony Romo, 8 games played. He's going to the Pro Bowl for the NFC. When you look at the starters, you got Drew Brees out of New Orleans. You can't argue with that.
Right.
Mark Bulger, Tony Romo. Ryan, should Vic have been on that Pro Bowl team?
Bulger is questionable.
Ryan. You're Doug. I'm Ryan. Okay. I'm Ryan. You better believe Vic should have been on that team, okay? He just does so much. You can't let Tony Romo, who's an outstanding story, I think if Tony Romo was a Minnesota Viking or a Jacksonville Jaguar, that it wouldn't be that big of a deal. But because he's a Dallas Cowboy, it means so much. I got something I want to tell you guys. Tony Romo, 6-2, 98 quarterback rating right now. Damon Hewitt, 5-2, and also a fourth rated passer in this league.
He lost his job.
Yeah, but guess what? He's threw 11 touchdowns and he threw one interception. Romo's 16 touchdowns and 10 interceptions. Damon Hewitt should be on this team before Tony Romo. You can't be a Pro Bowler after 8 games. There's so much football to be played, and he hasn't played it. I'm sorry, guys. I'm a big Romo fan. I think he's done an outstanding job.
But
he should not be on this list ahead of Michael Vick.
Do you agree with this?
Oh, yeah. Bottom line, Romo shouldn't be on the team ahead of Michael Vick. And I would even question Bulger. If you look at the year that Bulger's had, Mike Martz isn't at St. Louis anymore. He hasn't had the years he's had in the past. Michael Vick has been to 2 consecutive Pro Bowls, like I mentioned earlier, 3 total. And you're going to put a guy that started 8 games in the NFL.
Make your case for Romo. Do you think
you got to be kidding me?
I'm going to make my case against Michael Vick. And I'm going to tell you what just happened.
Oh my God.
Okay. Who votes for this, Mr. Football Player?
Okay.
Football players and coaches vote for this, right? That's the majority of the votes for this. Mm-hmm. The coaches and the players just made the statement that I just made to you guys. Michael Vick doesn't belong at quarterback in the Pro Bowl. That's what they just said. Who won the game Saturday night head-to-head? Who outplayed whom in Atlanta? In Atlanta, in your city.
He threw five touchdowns.
Romo outplayed Michael Vick. Let me ask you this. On the key play of the game, the game-turning 4th-and-1, what does Michael Vick do? He doesn't see Algie Crumpler standing over there saying, please throw me the football. He tries to throw it to Ashley Lalee 15 yards
downfield. Why are we throwing it in 4th-and-1 in the first place? It goes back to Greg Knapp
being
somewhat
open.
I
would agree with you. Greg, take a nap. That's what I always call
problem. If he had a guy like Belichick or a guy like Billick making the calls, it'd be a totally different story.
And let me ask you this. Okay, at the end of the game, when the game is on the line and it's time to be a man, Michael Vick wimps out and walks off the field.
The guys threw five touchdown passes last week.
No. Guys, you know what?
To Skip's point, they were making the point during the telecast, too. Deion Sanders, would you be in the game? I'd be in the game. They made it very clear he should have been on the field. Why wasn't he?
He pulled his groin. He tweaked his groin.
He's fine.
Without Michael Vick, this team has nothing. The guy threw 5 touchdown passes.
I just have to say one last thing. Please, Jay, please. You guys are just saying this because you want to say what your listeners want you to say.
You got to be kidding me.
Am I right?
You're part of the propaganda machine.
No, I'm telling the truth. You guys know in your heart.
Skip.
You know in your heart.
Oh, my gosh. Skip.
You know in your heart that I'm right.
When Vick removed himself from the game, was the game over?
Oh, my Lord.
When Vick removed himself from the game, was it over?
Oh, my Lord.
For our broadcast purposes, we're going to take a commercial break.
Game was over.
You know what?
But I can assure you that during the commercial break, this will continue. That's it for second down. Ahead in third down, Tom Brady is out. Phillip Rivers is into the Pro Bowl. We're going to debate that. That's probably going to be just as strong. And is Steve Nash heading for a third straight MVP? Your time is done. We'll debate that next. Also ahead on Cold Pizza, Steve McNair might have some trouble airing it out against Pittsburgh. We'll tell you if a hand laceration will keep the Ravens quarterback out of the lineup against the Steelers. Also from the NBA, Kobe Bryant scored a combined 98 points in two games. Find out if he could keep it going against the Bulls in Chicago last night. The highlights are straight ahead.